when I went up to Oxford as an undergraduate, it was 1970, and I went there to read physiology and psychology. And what happened was, you know, there was Freshers' Fair and all these societies you could join and all this kind of thing. And amongst lots of other things, I joined the Society for Psychical Research. And then I thought nothing of it, nothing happened, and I thought nothing of it. And a couple of weeks later, I was in my room in college, and this second year turned up, and he had long, wavy hair down here. He was really, we'll say cool now, but I don't know what we said in those days, you know. anyway, he was just, I thought he was terrific. And he said, I'm the only surviving member of the Society for Psychical Research. Would you like to start it up again with me? So I thought, yeah, all right. So I did. And he and I then ran the society. In fact, he got sent down for not doing the work. And I then took over and ran the Oxford University Society for Psychical Research for the whole 3 years I was there. And I got gripped by the subject. You know, we invited psychics and mediums and occultists and clairvoyants and all of these different people to come and give lectures. And I was impressed with them and believed all, you know, the stories they told about their experiences and what they could do. And we had Ouija board sessions 2 or 3 nights a week in my room. Not something I would advise people to do, stupid thing to do, but anyway, we did. I joined a coven and began training as a witch and all sorts of interesting things. I learned to read the tarot cards, which I was reasonably good at, and was utterly convinced that they, you know, could really tell fortunes.